Good morning, all of you. We'll continue with the nuclear physics. The binding energy, I think we have stopped yesterday. We'll move from here. So today's class will be binding energy per nucleon, stability of nucleus, and we'll introduce ourselves to the radioactivity phenomena. So why that radioactivity will occur, that particular, some theoretical ideas, formulas, we'll derive that one. Please ask only questions related to the topic because it's a wide topic. Because it's a we can just discuss for 2, 3, 4 days continuously non-stop because unlimited. So let's see on Friday or Saturday if you get any time, we can discuss other than the syllabus, that one. Let me bind only to the syllabus. Your questions, queries should be related to only syllabus. Don't put in chat any other question except the syllabus one. And personal thing also, nothing that one. If you are in afterwards, you can put in WhatsApp, no? Why to share during class only? Control your emotions and don't put anything other than the subject related. Okay, we have started with binding energy, no? So they're the, in a simplest way, so as far as our numerical part is concerned, like it's the energy that should be supplied to break up the nucleus into its constituents. Or it's the energy that must be what happened? Will be available when the constituents will form a nucleus, that one. And that binding energy per nucleon is what will help us to define the stability. Now let's see that the nucleus, what all that binding energy further, what all it, we have shown one method. We have shown one particular method. Let's go for a general, the more exact form, the binding energy. This is what I discussed previous class. It is one of the method. Still what happened? We can express still more in depth based on the conditions of the nucleons, pairing, all that everything matters here. I think this will be, can be asked as a general passage. So let me proceed like this. So if you take the nucleus, this one. So inside the nucleus, in nucleons will be there. Let me give some number like that. All will be of same size. I'm unable to draw them. Okay, we'll look at this 35, then we'll These are the numbers. I think I numbered everything. You look at the one. So what is the nuclear force? Nuclear force is a short range force, no? So altogether, how many? I think what is the maximum? So we took around 65 nuclei. So total number of nuclei, how many are there? Total number of nuclei are 65. Is it each and every nuclei will interact with every other nuclei? The answer is no. So now if you look at the nucleus one, what happened? Will interact with 28, 27, 17, 2, 3, 18, 29. Will interact with these surroundings. Will interact with these surroundings. So I'll just only take one, I'll explain. I think the middle one, let me write one. No, let's take the one. One is our center point of this one. Let it interact. Let's see that with what all it's interacting. Let me focus only on one. Now, if you look at the one, is it interacting all the nucleons, all the nucleons? The answer is no. Total number of nucleons. Sorry, this is total number of nucleons is 65. That one. So one is interacting with what? Say 2, 7, 15, or you can say within this boundary. So somewhere till here, what happened? It is able to interact. One cannot interact with, say, like a 40, 43, or 65, or 61. Any reason for that? Nuclear force is a short range force. So this will be, say, like a by the time this will be 1 femtometer. And how much this distance will become between 1928? Maybe greater than 1 femtometer. Then what is the distance between 1 and the 53 year? So that will become more than 1.5 or around 2 femtometer. And what is the distance between 1 and 61 will become around 2.5. And according to the graph, if the distance becomes more than 2.5, already there is interaction. Just around 2, 2.5, the distance between the nucleons become more than 2 or 2.5, there won't be interaction. So shall I say that the interaction gets because of saturation, because the nuclear force gets saturated. Yesterday I drawn one curve, you have to recollect that. So therefore, the interaction depends also on the distance between nucleons. So one will not interact with all the nucleons. So let me focus only on one. So what are the points? I'll put it one by one. Nucleon one will interact strongly with, say, what are the surroundings? 3, 5, 15, 2, 3, 5, 2, 3, 5, 15, 17, 18. Let me come in order. 2, 3, 5, 15, 17, 19. 4 is also there, no? Yeah. Will interact with this strongly, that one. Next, if you go for outside, so I'll give different colors that interaction. I'll give different colors. So if I, there's a strong interaction. Rough to make you understand. So what happened to the one? One will interact with six. What happened to interaction? Will decreases. So as you move away, the interaction it decreases here. So this, you look at this, the green color. So the interaction decreases. With respect to one, we'll discuss the problem so that we'll understand this one. So what happened now? So nucleon one will interact strongly. So what happened to next year? Interact moderately, I'll say. Moderately with green colored nucleons. Green colored, rather than numbering, no, I'll write like this. Green colored nucleons. This is what? Nucleon one will have very weak, I'm using word, very weak और नो इंट्रैक्शन। नो इंट्रैक्शन विथ व्हाट कलर्स हियर? Because they're far away, and a nuclear force is what? Short range force, no? No interaction with brown colored nucleons. So like this, what happened? The whether the nucleus is stable or not will determine how many nucleons, means most of the nucleons, if they have strong interaction with nearby nucleons, then the nucleus is to be stable. Later on, the stability, I'm going to take help of the same condition. So this is what happens here. Now the same thing, now it's not only one. Sir, I'll take 12. Now if you look at the 12, this particular thing, if you look at this particular 12, the 12 will interact very strongly with this. Next it will almost interact with this. And the 12 open will weakly interact with 39. Also like these particular things. The 12 open will weakly interact here. Or if you look at the adjacent, the 43 and 39, they will, shall I say, weakly interact. The 43, what happened? Will weakly interact, almost there's no interaction. So like this, as the nuclear force is a short range force, so the interaction between the nucleons depends also on the distance. So almost you can say it gets saturated, no interaction between 39 and 43. So all the nucleons at open are not strongly bound. So these outermost nucleons, shall I say, that they're weakly bound. So inside the nucleus, what I notice that the outermost nucleons are weakly bonded. Weakly bonded. And moreover, you come for, if you look at the 39, 43, if you see 1, 9, 15, so let me take the one and the nucleon 15. So there'll be an interaction force. The nuclear force I should not show, but to make you understand, I'll show like this, not straight line, something. So there's a nuclear force. So let both be proton, 1, 9, 15. Let both be proton. There'll be electrostatic force also will be acting. But here what will happen? Fn will be very much greater than electrostatic force, as they are very tightly bound, 1 and 15. But if you look at the 43 and 39, if you look at the 43 and 39 and 43. If you look at the 39 and 43, so what is the nuclear force? Is almost zero. And let there be proton. Let there be proton. In that case, what will happen? The electrostatic force, again, it's a long range force. At a distance of order few femtometer, the electrostatic force will not be dominant. Once the distance becomes 3 or 4, 5 femtometer, no, the electrostatic force will be dominant. Fe will be dominant. Here what happened? Fe is weak. Because the long range force, at a distance less than femtometer, it will be 2 or 1 femtometer, no? The electrostatic force will be weak and the nuclear force will be dominant here, no? This is what practically happened. So like this, what happened? So many conditions will come and the binding energy depends also on this, is what I wanted to tell you that one. So when the distance between nucleons becomes greater than 3 femtometer, almost the nuclear force will become zero. No, I think a graph, I explained everything there. That graph is what actually you're supposed to keep in mind. You have to measure the distance between nucleons, whether they'll interact or not. And sometimes it'll be repulsive. Repulsive between what? Between nucleons, if they come very close. Of course, we'll not bother with the repulsive force here. Only attractive force is what we'll discuss about this one. I'll not show Fn, second case, because it's not at all existing, got saturated. So, and the density is uniform. So like this, what happened? Inside the nucleus is what? I see the what we encounter, the nuclear force as well as electrostatic force. Then I will take help of to explain the binding energy. Binding energy, still I gave a formula. One more we have, like a, it's called like a liquid drop model. Now this is a, can be asked in general pathway. So let me just elaborate it. It's not there in syllabus, but still they can ask you in general passage. So regarding the nucleus, what happened? They just proposed it here. So what are the binding energy? Binding energy, I'll directly write formula. Then we'll express all the quantities one by one. Plus or minus C5 e to power of 4 by 3, minus 4 by 3. Okay, like this, what happened? There's a total binding energy. Of nucleus. What is A? A is a mass number, I think. Mass number or total number of nucleons. So the binding energy depends on what? The first one, what is that C1? It depends upon also the mass number here telling. So if as the number of nucleons increases, what will happen to the interaction? Will decrease. If more nucleons are there, so what happened to the interaction between the individual nucleons? Will decrease, no? So a given nucleon, what happened? Suppose the previous discussion what we made, the one will interact with only surrounding. So that particular nuclear interaction sort will also contribute for the binding energy. To address that nuclear interaction, the interaction between nucleons, what we have brought this one, and the value of C1, practically what happened, we are able to generate it is equal to around C1 is equal to 17 point or 15 point. Not exactly, it's average value. Different books, they give slightly different values. Mega electron volt. Now what is this? So what is the conclusion we can write? A given nucleon will interact with only adjacent neighboring nucleons, and because of that, what happens? The binding energy, shall I say, that depends upon the proportion, directly proportional to number of nucleons. So what is the reason for that? The binding energy, I think we'll write individually. This C1A, we'll write explanation here rather than, because a given nucleon. Now, why do that energy? I'm giving explanation. A given nucleon will interact. With adjacent nucleons only. This one, and because of this, what happened? With nearest or adjacent nearby nucleons only. So because of this, so what you can say, this effect gives a binding energy term that is proportional to number of nucleons. So if the more number of nucleons are there, as binding energy will increase here. So therefore, this effect, and as the distance increases, what happened again? It gets saturation mode, will means the nuclear force will get saturated, and the interaction will decrease here. So this interaction depends on what? If more nucleons are there, more interaction. Shall I put in simplest way? See, like it's not that, see, like if there are, so what is the meaning of this? If there are two are there, so one interaction, three nucleons, how many interactions? One, two, three. If there are four, how many interactions? 1, 2, 3, 4. So like that, as the number of nucleons increases, what happens to number of interactions will increase. So the number of interactions also will contribute for binding energy. That's a logical way of thinking, nothing big. So what we can say that one, this effect gives a binding energy. That is proportional to number of nucleons. S.C. Verma, he has discussed all property of nucleus. He didn't write equation. You see the theory, you know, what all he has explained at one end of page. Nothing but this equation only, but he didn't write this equation. Not to trouble students here. Just I'm bringing explanation, what all he has wrote that explanation. You know, for that, I'm expressing mathematically. What do you mean by that? Okay, this is about, so the binding energy also depends on what number of nucleons. Okay, next after this. So what is that next term? C2A minus C2A to power of 2 by 3. Those nucleons which are on the surface will have less interaction. Those nucleons. On the surface of the nucleus are less tightly bound than those in the interior, because they have no neighbor outside the surface. I think I'll write only this much. Further, we need not to elaborate much here. Again, the diagram is there. Look at the brown color one. What is the problem with that? Just look at the number 41. Yes, it is able to interact with 43, 42, 40, or maybe to some extent these things. So they're not tightly bound, no? Because there are no nucleons on this side. So they're not tightly bound. So they're loosely bound. And moreover, if electrostatic force will come, still more it is, no? If you look at the 43, there'll be nuclear force will be acting. But it'll be very less interaction with it. So what happened? The electrostatic force will be dominating. So these nucleons are very loosely bound. So what they do? They decrease the binding energy. So those nucleons which are on the surface, what happened? They are not tightly bound. They will have less interaction. And moreover, electrostatic force will also come. So to express that effect will bring like this. That's why the negative sign. Why negative sign understood? So the reason why we bring negative sign. And it is proportional to radius. No. It also radius of the nucleus, so as the radius of the mass number increases, radius will also increase. So therefore, the expression is adjusted like this here. It's simple. What is the surface area? 4 pi r square. And what is the radius? R square. And what is r equal to? R naught a to power of 1 by 3. Why a to power of 2 by 3 will come? Able to understand? Substitute this r there. Surface area of the nucleus equal to 4 pi r square. And we know radius equal to r naught a to power of 1 by 3. So this surface effect, what happened, will decrease the binding energy. That's what I mean to say. That's why negative sign is brought here. Why a to power of 2 by 3? We can give some explanation like this here. And then, so next again, what is the term? C3Z minus 1 A3. Denominator is there. Every one of the Z proton will ripple Z into Z minus, or Z minus will ripple Z minus 1 protons. Z minus other protons. This is what practically happens here. So now the total repulsive electrostatic potential energy. So you know electrostatic potential energy, what we write, this should be equal to say some Q charge Z with other all Z minus 1, 4 pi epsilon naught R. And what is this R? R, we can bring it as R naught A to the power of 1 by 3. So why the denominator A to the power of 1 by 3? Because it has come like this. And why Z into Z minus 1? The interaction. When I add up all, roughly, so we'll end up equation of like this. So every one of Z proton will ripple the other protons and the interaction potential in G. I think this will come in the next step. The electrostatic. Interaction potential energy is given by, so because of this, and what this electrostatic repulsive force, it's a repulsive force, electrostatic interaction potential energy. So what happened to the protons? Constantly they'll be experiencing the repulsive force, and that repulsive force, what happened, will try to decrease the binding energy. So what you can say, the repulsive force between protons will decrease the binding energy of nucleus. Why it will decrease? See, what do you mean binding energy? If they are more tightly binded, more binding energy. So this repulsive force, what happens, will try to increase the distance between the nucleons. No, so the binding energy will decrease here. The repulsive force between protons will decrease the binding energy of nucleus, or will increase distance between nucleons. So therefore it has to be negative. So it will contribute for negative. The binding energy depends on this interaction also between the protons. So more number of protons per pen, definitely per pen. Yes, that definitely the stability will decrease here. The fourth one. What is the fourth one? C4 by A. Yeah. This is something based on stability. Yeah? For stability, so we know A is equal to N plus Z. A should be equal to N. For stability, what the nucleus will do? Z should be as small as possible, no? If N is more. For stability, if N greater than Z, that will, N should be greater than Z for stability. What happens if N is less than Z? If more protons are there, what happens? More repulsive force will come, and it will decrease the stability. So for that purpose, a nucleus must possess, it should try to have more number of neutrons than protons. So definitely that N minus Z, what happens? If it is greater than 1, yes, then definitely what happens? You can say it's said to be more stable. So in a, and that what happened, it should be in the lower state, that one. So that particular thing what happened, we express using this quantity, and it's also negative. So further, what you can write, A equal to N minus Z, no? So A equal to N plus Z. So if you write A equal to N plus Z here in this equation, this will lead to N minus Z. And below what will happen, we'll get N plus Z. So here this quantity should be more in the denominator, and here the N plus Z, that one. So like this, what happened? So that N minus Z is what matters a lot. If N minus Z, if value is greater, no, then it's said to be more stable. At the same time, N plus Z will come in the denominator. So that particular parameter, what happened, will affect the binding energy of the system. So for that purpose, what happened, we have introduced that quantity also. Even the number of neutrons, protons, their number matters a lot for the stability of that atom. So that will also have influence on the binding energy. In short, I'll write it, because at your level, I think very difficult to go in depth, because again, I have to go for quantum state. I'll just wind up this one. And the last one, it depends upon the pairing of nucleons. Suppose say the pairing can be positive or negative. So, pairing of protons and neutrons, that one. So if both the pairing can, what happens, can be such that it can be positive or negative. If both Z and N are even, pairing of what? Pairing of proton and neutron. Nuclear force favors pairing of protons and neutrons. Okay, this one. If the pairing is even, then it will be positive. Pairing is odd, then what happens? It's said to be negative, that one. So like that, even the pairing of neutrons, protons also matters here. So just okay, the pairing of nucleons or pairing of protons and neutrons. Even this will also influence the binding energy. And the pairing can be positive, negative. If both Z and N are even, less binding energy. If both Z and N are odd, then what happens? It'll be zero, or it can be positive here. So that pairing, again, we have to go for Pauli's exclusion principle. So based on that, it'll come. So like this, the binding energy, it depends on all so many parameters. And roughly what happened? C1, C2 experimental will determine. I think in books, different books, they give a different value. I'll just leave it. Let's not bother here. So therefore, the stability of particular nucleus, if you are discussing, not just like one parameter. So all these are to be considered here. And the binding energy, in fact, depends. We don't use this method. I already shown yesterday how to calculate binding energy. I'll calculate the mass of the nucleus and the mass of the nucleons. The difference of that, what happened, will give the binding energy. And binding energy per nucleon. This is the overall, the idea of this particular thing. So what happened is, in a simplest way, so let's get into the stability now. Because now we have a certain idea. Stability of a nucleus. When I compare the stability of a nucleus, what I see is that this is the N equal to Z. So the stability curve initially for lighter nuclei will be N equal to Z. For heavier nuclei, it will favor N greater than Z. So there are two parts are there. O, A. OAB like this. So this is OA, that one. Look at this, OA will become lighter nuclei. So if you look at the nucleus, lighter nuclei, they will have N equal to Z. For lighter nuclei, for stability, they prefer N equal to Z. Heavier nuclei, for stability, they prefer N greater than Z. So when I check like this, there's a stability curve. When I check it, no, all the nucleides are not stable. Even lighter nuclei, few are unstable. So suppose say like here, I'll write the number. I think the books they're given this way. Let me write. What is the dots? What are the dots? Dots are the nucleides. So what we see that there are some nuclei. Let me show few outside. It will be meaningful. If you look at the lighter nuclei, all the lighter nuclei are not stable. few what's happened, those which are stable, I see that n equal to that. And few what happen, the lighter nuclei, n will not be equal to that, and they're not stable. And when I go for the heavier nuclei, n greater than that, no doubt. Then though n greater than that, still what happens, some heavier nuclei are not stable. So is it all lighter nuclei stable? No. Those which will lie on stability curve. What is the stability curve? This region is what? Stability curve. I'll shade it. There's a region, and you have to extend that yellow color line till further here. So that what all you see yellow, that is the stability, that one. So yellow color shaded. Shaded region indicates stability. Is it all lighter nuclei stable? No. Few are lying outside, no. And is it all heavier nuclei stable, though n greater than that? No. Few are lying outside. You can see this. You can see this. So here we'll indicate few more. Getting this one? So is it all lighter nuclei stable? No. Though n equal to z, and some what happen are satisfying n equal to z stable, and some what happen slightly n. Suppose it 4 protons, 4 neutrons. So some are having what happen like a 5 protons and 1 neutron. So like a 4 neutrons. They're not stable. So all lighter nuclei are not stable, and all heavier nuclei are stable. So n greater than that. But what is happening? Most of the heavier nuclei where n greater than that, they're stable. And look at the lighter nuclei where n equal to that, they're stable. But all lighter nuclei are not stable, though n equal to that. So this shows that there is some stability, just you can't define with this particular condition. A nuclei, what happened? Lighter nuclei to attain stability, it will prefer n equal to that. Heavier nuclei to attain stability. Why n greater than that? Because if more protons are there, those protons which are at nearby the surface of nucleus, diametrically opposite, their interactions will be very poor, no? And the stability of nucleus will decrease by a very large amount. So then it lead to instability, that one. So therefore what the nucleus will do, it will try to have more neutrons than protons, as in fact we see that one. But all heavier nuclei are not stable, all lighter nuclei are not stable. So few where n equal to that, they're stable. Few nuclei where n greater than that, they're stable. But all heavy nuclei are not stable. So therefore, this particular the line, what is this line? N equal to z. I think it's not expressing the it will not exactly telling us the information. What we have to give reason why, though lighter nuclei they're having still some anywhere n equal to that, why they're still unstable. Though heavier nuclei they're having n greater than that, why they are unstable. That explanation we have to give. So for that what we'll go for binding energy per nucleon. We know how to calculate binding energy. Like that, I'll calculate binding energy per nucleon. The binding energy per nucleon is what giving explanation. Those particular nucleides where binding energy per nucleon is maximum, they are said to be stable. So shall we put a condition that all lighter nuclei are not stable, though n equal to z. All heavier nuclei, though n greater than z, are not stable. So definitely this curve is not at all explaining us anything that why few are stable, why few are unstable. So it's of not much use. It will not give exact reason here. So what is the conclusion I'll make it? All lighter nuclei though n equal to z. All heavier nuclei are not stable, though n greater than that. But what I see, there are few nuclei where n greater than they are stable. I think this is not something exact reason. No? Are you trying to understand? Stable means they don't further, they will remain as it is. Iron is there, should be iron only, even after 1,000 years, 10,000 years. Gold. It should not become silver. It should be gold only. There's a meaning of stable. All lighter nuclei are not stable, though n equals that. All heavy nuclei are not stable, though n greater than z. So this is not exact reason what we can, but the nuclear, what happened, every nuclear will try to prefer more neutrons than protons for stability, but still they are not stable. So therefore, what is the reason now? So how to expect the stability? The stability, what happened, will go for binding energy per nucleon. With the help of that curve, we can define the binding energy, the stability curve very easily. So we can give exact reason. So those nuclides which are having binding energy per nucleon more, and they are said to be stable. And those nuclei which are having less binding energy per nucleon, they are less stable is what? Like this, what happened? We make a firm conclusion. Okay, now let me draw the curve. One curve is there. Just a theoretical idea, nothing is there. How to calculate binding energy? Already we have just discussed in a rough way. There's a mass number A. This is binding energy. Nucleon, this will be in terms of mega electron. So in books, we just call like this, binding energy per nucleon. So if you look at the maximum, it is so in terms of 2, let this be 2, 4, 6, and 8. Iron, it is 8.5. So this will be 50. Yeah, let me take this is 50, 100, 150, 200, 250. The curve, almost all books, the same method is giving. Fifty-six iron will come here, no? Yeah, this will be iron. Next nitrogen, how much will be 39. One more color. A 10 mega electron volt. No, first we'll show the iron. Iron will be around, it is 8.51. 56, it will be. Nitrogen also will be more than 8. Below it will be one will be deuterium, tritium, 3 it will be. You need not to remember helium, lithium, and the curve will join it. Arsenic will be 70, no, around, yeah, 70. How much what is the lead PB? No, lead symbol. Okay, not needed. I'm saying uranium. So we'll go for bismuth. Bismuth, anybody? Number 209. Oh, yeah, 209. Uranium 238. 209 will come here. Uranium will be 238. And the stability curve. This is the iron. Fe. So this is the bismuth. Two not nine and 83 uranium, 238, 92. This is a deuterium, tritium, helium, then lithium, oxygen. Nitrogen. I'm just showing few. So if you refer book, they have shown plenty of that one. So to just put like every nuclear, though n greater than that, you can look at that. They give you number of protons and number of neutrons. Though they are more open, it is unstable. It is still unstable. And if you look at the middle weight, so what you do classify this into two parts. This is called like a lighter weight. Heavier nuclei. These are called as a middle weight. Why middle weight are more stable? Because they're having more binding energy per nucleon. So those particular nucleides which are having more binding energy per nucleon, they are more stable. So some undate. So let this be. What is the name of this? ZR. You look at this middle weight, 75, 33. Look at this one. So these are middle weight, no? They are stable. And lighter nuclei, look at this, they're unstable. They're unstable. Then what about heavier nuclei? Though n greater than that, they're unstable. The reason for that, binding energy per nucleon. Why the middle weight only are more stable? So if you look at that particular nucleon, 56 nucleons, no? So I think you take marble, then you take Fevicol. Fevicol, all of you know, Fevicol you take. Fevistik will be very cautious, you take Fevicol. Then you just place marbles, like connect it. So what happened to a given marble? So in the diagram, I'm showing around six, but what happened, practically what happened, I think around some 14 or 16 marbles, what happened, a given one marble can come in contact with those things, or those many marbles. If you take the marbles, what happened, if you start connecting them, no? So like this here also, marbles will be there. So, and next again, you put marbles. Like this, you keep on join them. So those marbles, those around, if you take the marbles which are around the range from, say, like a 50 to almost you can say around 100, then what happen, a given this marble will have more interaction with all, because what happen, the surface area will not decrease much. And as you increase the atomic number, the number of nucleons increase, the surface area increases. As surface area increases, what happen, those molecules or those nucleons which are at surface, what happen, they'll have less interaction. No, sir, here also, but if you look at this and you draw some 100 or 200 nucleons, if you draw 50 nucleons, the distance between these nucleons, what happen, will be still around less than 2 femtometer. But when you draw 100 nucleons, 100 nucleons like this, and the distance between these nucleons you take it, it'll be more than, so it'll happen around 2.5 or around 4 or 7 femtometer it will come. So they show that they are weakly bonded, though they lie on the surface diametrically opposite, but the distance between these two, how much it is, around less than 2.5. So they're interacting strongly. But as you increase the number of nucleons, so suppose at 200 nucleons you draw it, when you take these two nucleons, the distance between them, what happened, will become more than 2.5. It'll come around 5 or 7 or 6, that one. Then what happened, nuclear force will become very weak. And by chance, if they become proton, the electrostatic force will dominate here. And they are unstable. They call it a surface effect here. So shall we put like this? For the middle weight nucleons, what happened? The nucleons are where the given nucleon will interact with more number of nucleons. And hence they are tightly bound. The binding energy per nucleon will be more. Lighter weight, what is the problem with the lighter weight? Lighter weight, what happened? Suppose you take 3. What is the interaction? It's only 3, no? You come for this. This given nucleon will interact with more number, no? Here what happened? Though there are only 3, less interaction. Sir, what about here? Here also more nucleons, more interaction, but you look at this outer nucleon. I'm not talking about the inside nucleons, somewhere here. These nucleons, what happened, will have less interaction. Don't talk only the one which is middle. One which is middle, okay, no, not a problem. The one which are on the surface is a problem. So only 3 interactions, very weak interaction. So therefore, what will happen here? They are not stable. Middle weight, a given nucleon, either you take this nucleon or this nucleon, will have very more interactions. Even this nucleon will interact with this also. Of course, it will be less than this nucleon. So therefore, here what will happen? You can say the interaction between nucleons is more and they're very tightly bound. So therefore, they're stable. What about every nucleon? This nucleon, no problem. Huh? It's a tightly bound. What about those on surface? They're not tightly bound. So like this, as the number of nucleons increase, the surface area increase, the surface effect, what it'll do? These nucleons, what happens, are not tightly bound. So because of that, stability will not come into picture. So this effect we show how to year after define stability. Just take the binding energy per nucleon. When I plot the binding energy per nucleon curve with mass number, then what happened? I got a curve. Then those which are stable, what happened? They're having more binding energy per nucleon. So therefore, year after to define the stability, I'll prefer the binding energy per nucleon because that will help us a lot than any other quantity. So therefore, this has made now universal. A good example now, you can see that one. Deuterium, tritium. It's helium is stable. But lithium again, not stable. Tritium, deuterium. Again, bismuth, uranium. So these are not stable. So like this, what happened? We'll get a overall explanation like this. So to define stability, what happened? We prefer binding energy per nucleon because it is giving exact reason. So like this, what happened? In SEOLMA, that surface effect, everything that already I explained in the binding energy equation systematically there. So all this, what we put it, to explain stability, what happened? We do prefer binding energy per nucleon because that will give exact reason. Okay, now one which are stable, it's of, let's not bother, no? So I'll shade it like this. We'll do one thing. Middle weight, these are so we'll give name. These are avian nuclei. Middle weight nuclei. These are lighter nuclei. Okay, let's get into. So I am bothered about now what? That avian nuclei, which is stable. So to attain stability, what it will do? Let's come back to this equation. Now look at this particular thing. You look at this particular dot. It is unstable, no, because it doesn't lies in this stability region. Yellow color shaded region indicates stability. Now look at this particular. It is what happened. It's unstable. So more what happened if it can decrease some neutrons. Say if it decreases two neutrons, two protons, it can attain stable, no. And look at this particular thing. Nearby stability curve. So to attain stability, what it can do? If it can decrease one proton, and look at this, if it can decrease one neutron, it will enter stability. So like that, what happens? Those nuclei, which are there nearby stability curve, if they can decrease few protons or neutrons, they can attain stability. And which are far away, what they do? Suppose they are far away. They will decrease neutrons, protons, like that. Or they sometimes they decrease both neutrons, protons. Sometimes they decrease only neutrons, only protons. Like that, what happens? They keep on decrease their nucleons to attain the stability. So what this heavier nuclei will they do? To attain stability, what they do? They will decrease their number of nucleons. How do they can decrease here? As a phenomena will occur where it will decrease nucleons. So if it decrease means for that, what it should do to attain stability, what happens? The nucleus, what happens, starts emitting nucleons. It starts giving out nucleons. This particular phenomena is called like a radioactivity, which we are going to study here. So those which are unstable, what they do to attain stability, what will happen? They will decrease their number of nucleons. So the nucleus starts emitting nucleons. And that particular phenomena is what called a radioactivity. That particular radioactivity. So what are the possible types of particles that will be emitted? So next we'll go for nuclear reactions. I'll have water. When the atom will be stable, if the nuclear force and electrostatic force, if the somehow they act in such a way that they'll get balanced, then they'll be stable. That's what happens in case of middleweight. What happens to heavier nuclear? The electrostatic force will dominate on the long range force will dominate on the nuclear force. Same thing here also, like the electrostatic force is able to dominate the nuclear force. Because of that, they're unstable. Where the nuclear force and the electrostatic repulsive force, if they are able to balance each other, it will be stable. So those particular nuclei where the electrostatic force dominates over nuclear force, then what happens? They'll become unstable. And to attain the stability, what that particular nuclei do, then they'll better try to decrease the number of nucleons. They decrease the number of nucleons. So because of that, particular what happens? As it decreases the number of nucleons, we'll say decay. It will just decay on its own. It will decrease the nucleus. No need of any external agent. The nucleus, what happened, will take a decision, and to attain stability, what happened? It will start emitting the nucleons from its nucleus. This particular phenomena is called like a radioactive decay, that one. Or this is called like a disintegration. Spontaneous disintegration. Disintegration means it will break up. It will try to break up, means it will kick out nucleons, that one. So again, it's a quantum mechanics. We have to go there. We don't have that much of ability to really trace into that particular thing. So like a story will make up things here. So first, if you take the radioactive substance, so I'll do one thing. I'll take a radioactive substance here. There's a uranium-238, best example. Then, so from here, what I see that, I'll get a particles. So these particular particles, what